Stop starving yourself. Diets just don't work.
Instead of dieting, I want you to learn about and eat more of the anti-cancer foods, because the same foods that inhibit cancer growth also block the storage of fat on your body and will keep you slim and healthy your whole life.
Dr. Joel Fuhrman is a board-certified medical doctor specializing in preventing and reversing disease through nutritional and natural methods.
The information you learn in this show will not only allow you to end dieting forever, but it will enable you to fix your blood pressure, lower your cholesterol, and give you a healthy emotional outlook on life.
Dr. Fuhrman is the New York Times best-selling author of Eat to Live, The End of Diabetes, Super Immunity, and the Eat to Live Cookbook.
I know deep down, if you really believed it was possible to live to 95 to 105 in good health without medical problems and suffering, wouldn't you drink the Kool-Aid? Why not have a great life and a long, healthy life too?
Join us for Dr. Fuhrman's End Dieting Forever. Here is Dr. Joel Fuhrman.
Hi, I'm Dr. Joel Fuhrman. Thank you so much for being here. I bet you don't know, if you follow some of the most popular diets, it could quadruple your risk of cancer. This information is critical for the future of America and your future. And I'll tell you why. It's because dieting is killing Americans, and the most popular diet books out there are very dangerous. That's right. And I want you to learn about this right here, and hopefully never go on one of those diets again. In this show, I am going to review scientific findings that expose these dangers. This is serious business, because the diet industry is spreading misinformation that is hurting and killing people. Only together can we put these predators out of business. After I share with you how harmful and lifespan shortening dieting is, I'm going to give you an effective alternative based on eating more food, not less. The secret is to eat lots of foods that inhibit fat storage on the body. The foods you can eat for the rest of your life that will keep you at a healthy weight forever. Instead of dieting, I want you to learn about and eat more of the anti-cancer foods, because the same foods that inhibit cancer growth also block the storage of fat on your body and will keep you slim and healthy your whole life. So in this program, though it's about weight loss, is really about longevity too, as it could add 20 quality years to your life. And as opposed to dieting, the difference is that with my nutritarian lifestyle, when the fat melts off your body, it'll stay off. The results are permanent, not temporary. And the side effect is that you will prolong your life and protect yourself from heart disease, strokes, dementia, and cancer all at the same time. And you won't ever have to count calories or eat small portions again. Thousands of people have done this now. People like Susan from New Jersey, who lost over 225 pounds and has kept it off for over 4 years. Susan was 380 pounds, and every diet she tried just made her heavier and heavier. She even had a lap band procedure years ago that made her so uncomfortable it had to be removed, and she wound up gaining weight from it. The difference is now she lost the weight for good. It will never come back. And of course, she no longer has high blood pressure or diabetes. These and her other medical problems are just distant memories. Remember, Susan is not on a diet and never went on a diet. She improved her diet to protect her health. Of course, Susan's results are hers. Yours may be even better. How many of you have dieted, lost weight, and then gained it back again? You're not alone. And what you don't know is that it's not your fault. First, you received the wrong information. And second, manufactured foods are designed to make you a food addict and set you up for food cravings that are just too hard to control. Here, you're finally going to get the right information that can set you free. We are the most obese, cancer-prone population with the worst health of all modern countries. That means Americans suffer with pain, loss of brain function, and an assortment of distressing medical problems. We're committing suicide with unhealthy and highly addictive processed foods. But this doesn't have to happen to you. 80% of Americans are overweight, and that means their BMI, or body mass index, is greater than 23. The healthiest, longest-lived populations are always slim, with BMIs that average 23 or below. A BMI of 23 is about 130 pounds for a 5'5" woman. Not only are most of us dangerously overweight, but almost all Americans over the age of 60 are already paying hundreds of dollars a month for blood pressure medications, cholesterol-lowering drugs, and drugs for emotional disorders. The information you learn in this show will not only allow you to end dieting forever, but it will enable you to fix your blood pressure, lower your cholesterol, and give you a healthy emotional outlook on life, protecting your life and saving you money on risky drugs and surgical procedures. Many of you are on diabetic drugs that cause weight gain, which can make you more diabetic. What I'm saying here is the simple dietary changes I'm going to outline in this presentation will have you lose your excess weight easily without dieting. And if you also have diabetes, high blood pressure, and high cholesterol, those problems will melt away. And your doctor can discontinue your medications as you simply won't need them anymore. And just like Susan, you will lose your food addictions and prefer eating healthfully. For example, in a study of diabetic patients who followed my program for an average of 7 months, they lost an average of 44 pounds, and over 90% were able to come off all their diabetic medications. That means almost all the participants did not just improve their diabetes, they got rid of it. They became non-diabetic. Their blood pressure and high triglycerides also normalized. Can you imagine if I can get most of America to watch this program and put it into action? Then 3/4 of physicians could get retrained to become electricians, mechanics, and engineers. Can you imagine you bring your car to the dealership for repair, and the guy comes out and introduces himself, and you recognize him as your former diabetes doctor? He says to you, "Don't worry, I'll take much better care of your car than I took care of your diabetes." We first must consider the diet most Americans eat, the standard American diet, often called the SAD, or SAD diet. The SAD diet is sad, sad that it's created an epidemic of heart attacks, strokes, and cancers, and a sickly, drug-dependent nation. We're eating ourselves to an early death in this country, and eating so much processed foods, sweets, and meats that it's making a nation of sickly and emotionally disturbed people. You see, Americans are eating predominantly processed foods and animal products. It seems unbelievable that over 55% of calories in the American diet is from sweets, processed grains, and oils. And if we remove the white potato, the total amount of fresh produce, like fruits and vegetables, is less than 6% of total calories. This is revealing because Americans are eating mostly animal products and commercially prepared baked goods and oils. And that means about 95% of calories Americans eat do not contain those nutrients that protect against cancer, specifically antioxidants and phytochemicals. Most foods you're eating promote weight gain because they stimulate fat storage hormones. Instead of burning the calories for energy, these hormones make sure what you eat gets turned into fat. If you're like most Americans, the only time your weight goes down is when you're in an elevator. All right, the two primary fat storage hormones are insulin and insulin-like growth factor 1, or IGF-1. Sugars, sweets, and white flour products raise insulin production, and insulin promotes cell growth and angiogenesis. I know some of you may have thought angiogenesis was the first book of the Bible, but it really means the growth of new blood vessels. So insulin promotes fat storage and the growth of blood vessels to supply the highways needed to bring glucose to fuel the growth of more fat. If you did not hormonally support angiogenesis, your body can't get fat. To make matters worse, the same foods that make you get fat promote cancer. A meta-analysis of 10 studies published in the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition on glycemic load and cancer demonstrated a dramatically heightened level of various cancers with those eating more sugar, white bread, white flour, and white rice. For example, a study published in the Asia-Pacific Journal of Clinical Nutrition demonstrated that for every 400 calories of white rice added to the diet, breast cancer rates went up 20%. I say, the whiter the bread, the sooner you're dead. Stay away from white flour, white sugar, white rice, white cigarettes, cocaine, heroin. Anything too white should make you nervous. But the most powerful inducer of cancer cell replication is excessive levels of IGF-1. It's called insulin-like growth factor because it's a hormone shaped like insulin, and it can bind to the insulin receptor and act like insulin. IGF-1 can powerfully promote growth, and that means growth of abnormal cells and cancer. And it promotes fat storage too. We know that it's mostly the processed foods in the American diet that promote excessive insulin, but it's the excessive amount of animal products in the American diet that promote dangerously high levels of IGF-1. Like turning on a spigot, when you increase the percentage of animal protein in a diet, IGF-1 is turned up accordingly. In this slide, reproduced from a study published in Aging Cell Journal, you can see low IGF-1 levels measured in vegans is below 150, and that is much lower even when compared to people restricting their calories in general, and the average American on the right with the highest levels. What we learned in elementary school about the value of high biological protein was upside down. Now we know that the lower biological value proteins in plants are more lifespan favorable and more than adequate for our body's needs for protein. Quite alarming is another huge investigation published in the journal Cell Metabolism. They followed thousands of people for 18 years in the 50 to 65 age range and found death rates went up 75% and cancer rate climbed 400% in those eating what researchers called a high protein diet. They considered the diet high in protein if it averaged 18% of calories from animal protein. But that's still less animal protein than most Americans are eating. This graph depicts the data in this study showing as a person's intake of animal protein increased, their risk of cancer and death went up accordingly. This means that if you eat 25 servings of animal products a week, such as meat, chicken, fish, cheese, or eggs, as most Americans do, you'll have a 400% increased risk of cancer and a 75% increased risk of dying prematurely compared to someone eating animal products 5 servings a week or less. But there's another critical point I'm making, and that is some of the most popular diets, such as Paleo diet or the Atkins or Dukan diet, are encouraging people to eat much more animal products, even more than twice as much as Americans generally eat. And that's twice as much as what these studies consider to be high protein. The increased risk of cancer from these popular high protein diets could be frighteningly higher, and certainly tremendous suffering and needless premature deaths is occurring because of this. And if you want to kill yourself as quick as possible, you can mix sweets in with the meats, pushing up insulin and IGF-1 simultaneously. Heightened levels of both those hormones are an important reason why Americans are so overweight and cancer-prone. Macaroni and cheese, a ham and cheese sandwich, meatballs and spaghetti, pizza, all these foods mix high glycemic carbohydrates together with the IGF-1 stimulating foods, creating a population burdened with life-destructive medical problems and food-induced deaths. That's why so many people think Darth Vader developed these common American foods. Okay, what you've learned so far is that the SAD diet is dangerous, and high-protein diets are dangerous. But I'm also going to show you why almost all other diets are dangerous too, and they don't even work. Scientific studies show that when you do lose weight on a diet, you're most likely going to gain it all back again, and then some. The amount of people that lose their excess body weight and keep it off for the rest of their lives is rare. Plus, when you go on a diet and lose weight and then gain it back again, you wind up worse off and at a higher risk of serious disease than if had you never lost the weight to begin with. The lipogenic enzymes, fat storage enzymes, are ramped up with caloric restriction. And after you lose some weight on a diet, those fat storage enzymes stay in an excited state for months, making weight regain occur quickly after you go off the diet. So if you go back to eating anything like you were before, you'll actually gain weight at an accelerated rate. And in most cases, even overshoot the weight you were before you began the diet. But there's another serious problem that develops. When you regain the weight that you lost, it deposits the fat somewhat differently. The fat is then stored more internally, in more dangerous places around your organs. You see, there are two types of fat on your body, subcutaneous fat and visceral fat. Subcutaneous fat is right under your skin. It's the fat you can pinch at your belly. But visceral fat is the fat behind the layer of abdominal muscle. You can't pinch it, as it's mixed in with your internal organs, deeper inside you. When you diet, you lose mostly subcutaneous fat. When you regain weight after dieting, you put back more visceral fat. So every time you go on one of those crazy diets, you increase the amount of visceral fat on your body, because it's visceral fat that makes you diabetic and is more cancer-promoting than the fat you had before you dieted. So if you want to get yourself closer to death, convert your subcutaneous fat to visceral fat by dieting and then gaining weight back again. When you yo-yo your weight up and down, it also increases your risk of heart disease because more fat is placed inside your blood vessels, too. That's why so many heart attacks occur on or right after holidays and vacations where people have gone off their diets and binged on food. So, four things happen to your fat stores after you diet and then gain some weight back. Number one, your stored fat becomes more visceral. Number two, your stored fat becomes more saturated. Number three, the blood vessels become more vulnerable. And number four, you become more insulin resistant and diabetic prone. Here are two women, the same age and weight. Do you know which one is more likely to have developed pre-diabetes already and headed for diabetes in a few years? And the one at higher risk of heart attack and cancer? It's Jill, the nurse on the left, because she's gone and off lots of those high-protein diets in the past and has lost and regained weight six times, whereas Jane just stayed overweight the whole time. You're going to be amazed how easy it can be to turn this all around, how easy it can be to get to your best, healthiest weight and stay there forever and end dieting forever. Don't you want that? What if you could do this and achieve great results in three simple steps? That means just three simple dishes I want you to eat each day. And all Americans can do this very easily. It's simple and simply delicious. And I am going to show you how this works and how to make it delicious. It'll work for you like it worked for thousands of others already, including lots of people right here in this theater, right? Stay tuned, because later in this program, I'm going to show you the latest findings in nutritional science that makes this work easily. The secret is in the magic of the weight loss-inducing foods you're going to learn about, foods found in every grocery store across America, so you never have to diet again. Thank you.
If you haven't, well, why not? Please keep great television right here by supporting more programs that make a difference in your life.
Welcome back to Dr. Furman's End Dieting Forever.
More than half of you are on diets. The other half of you are so frustrated with dieting that you've given up, thrown in the towel, checked out. Many of you are on one continuous binge, playing Russian roulette with food. Collectively, we're overweight, sickly, and struggling, just waiting for that first heart attack or cancer diagnosis. So many of you are not just overweight and unhealthy, you're also living in fear, just thinking you're eventually going to get cancer or have a heart attack. That's not good for you emotionally. It interferes with your happiness and feeling secure in life when you're fearful of these diseases that keep attacking everyone. These diseases are not natural. They're not the consequence of aging, and we can protect ourselves. But we've made it socially acceptable to use food like a recreational drug and we celebrate self-destructive eating and ostracize people who do not partake in the self-destruction. You see, the problem is that unhealthy foods are powerfully addicting, and the only way to get rid of food addictions, cravings, and out-of-control eating behavior is by flooding the body with the right nutrients from healthy foods. These nutrient-rich foods contain the micronutrients that can repair the distorted biochemistry causing the addiction and the overeating. Most diets have you restrict calories, struggle to eat less, or recommend some ratio of fat, carbohydrate, or protein that they claim will help you lose weight. Let's look at these concepts, because they're the problem, not the solution. If you try to eat less, you get even less micronutrients in your tissues, which just drives you into an uncontrollable binge. That doesn't work, because our bodies are starving for those nutrients. And avoiding fat or avoiding carbohydrates is not the answer either. Some people claim fat is bad and to be avoided like the plague, and other people blame carbohydrates. Some recommend a high-protein diet. Some recommend a high-carb diet. Some recommend low-fat. Others recommend high-fat. Wow, no wonder you're all so confused. Who do you believe? Clearly, there are too many cooks spoiling the brew, and their brew isn't good for you to begin with. Obviously, we need the right carbohydrates to fuel brain function and intelligence and positive emotions. I mean, the right fats to fuel brain function, intelligence, and to maintain a positive emotional outlook on life. So I'm here to tell you that you should throw all those diet books in the garbage. Throw them all away. But make sure you put them in the right recycling bin, not with the plastics and empty cans. It's all bad science. Now is the time to end this insanity. Now is the time to all agree on some basics that are impossible to deny. The scientific literature demonstrates that it's not the fat content or the carbohydrate content or not even the protein content of a diet that makes it good or bad. Focusing on those issues misses the entire main thrust of what's important in human nutrition. It's the nutritional quality of the fatty food, the nutritional quality of the protein-containing food, and the nutritional quality of the carbohydrate-containing food that matters. And low-nutrient carbs, fats, and proteins are the main reason we develop heart disease, cancer, dementia, and obesity. The main focus must be on achieving excellent micronutrient intake from natural whole foods. Micronutrients are vitamins, minerals, antioxidants, and phytochemicals. And micronutrients are present in copious amounts in fruits and vegetables, beans, nuts, and seeds. It's the consumption of micronutrient-rich foods that can repair your revved-up fat storage hormones and melt the disease-causing fat right off your body. It's the consumption of micronutrient-rich foods that can protect you against heart attacks, strokes, cancers, and dementia. So the question you should be asking before you put something in your mouth is, are the carbohydrates you are eating full of fiber and micronutrients or not? Are the fats you're eating from a whole food, like an almond, or made into a processed, into a faked food, like oil and poured out of a bottle? I want you to categorize foods into two main categories, fast food and slow food. Let me give an example of a fast food and a slow food, because the secret to losing weight and keeping it off forever is getting rid of the fast food and eating more slow foods. Let's talk about what fast food is first. Fast food can be eaten fast, it's digested fast, and it enters the body fast. And when this high caloric load enters quickly and all at once, that's a big problem because your body can't burn all those calories for energy. So it has to be converted to and stored as fat. The term fast food conventionally refers to foods found at fast food restaurants, where they're high salt, high calorie, highly processed, mass-produced fast food meals. Undoubtedly, eating at fast food restaurants is dangerous to one's health. They inject their French fries and breads, those high glycemic carbohydrates, with extra sugar and salt, and even pump the chemical-filled meats and cheeses with extra salt and sugar too. These weapons of mass destruction are present on almost every street corner in America. But I want you to categorize foods that flood the body with empty calories quickly as fast foods, too. I call the staple of the American diet fast food, especially foods made with sugar, flour, and oil, what I call the three stooges of American cuisine. When you eat a donut, for instance, the white flour and sugar enters the bloodstream within minutes and causes a spike in insulin, the body's response to the surge in glucose in the blood. Actually, it's so effective at stimulating fat storage that when you eat fat and sugar together, the body can store fat as efficiently as you injected the fat right on your waist with a syringe and needle. Then the fat or the donut gets stuck around your organs and heart and your waist just like reverse liposuction. Note on this graph that fast foods can enter the bloodstream rapidly and cause a caloric surge that stimulates fat storage hormones and dopamine release in the brain, which drives food addictions and cravings. The dopamine high is the same as taking narcotics or illegal drugs. These foods turn you into a Pac-Man in your own food cabinet. Slow foods, on the other hand, do the opposite. Note the slow foods, such as beans or nuts, their calories enter the bloodstream over a few hours, and the body can burn them for energy, not store them as fat, and they do not stimulate food craving receptors in the brain. When you eat slow foods, you simply desire fewer calories. When you eat fast foods, insulin and dopamine spike up high, and you become an eating machine. Let me show you some examples. Soft drinks, white bread, white rice, French fries, apple juice are foods with a high glycemic load, which enter the bloodstream rapidly. While, on the other hand, steel-cut oats, wheat berries, sesame seeds, azuki beans, and an apple all have a low glycemic load, which enter the bloodstream slowly. When the calories enter the bloodstream rapidly, insulin spikes up. That tells the body to ramp up the storage of fat. However, if you use an intact grain, such as steel-cut oats or wheat berries, then the exact same grain food has the opposite effect. The wheat berry is not finely ground into flour, but it can be soaked in water and cooked. It can be sprouted and coarsely ground to make a bread, a veggie mushroom patty, lots of different things. Likewise, the steel-cut oats could be made into a cereal, stew, soup, or dessert. But it's important to note that all oils are fast food. Here's sesame oil. It contrasted with whole sesame seeds. The difference, of course, is that at 120 calories a tablespoon, the oil is the most calorie-dense food you can eat. Eat 3 to 4 tablespoons of oil a day, as most Americans do, and no way could you lose your excess weight. It only takes 5 minutes from your lips to your hips, because your body can store that fat so efficiently and quickly, and the calories rush into the bloodstream so fast that the brain gets a dopamine rush, promoting food addictions, which drives more overeating behavior. And this goes for olive oil, too. If only Popeye could have known this, he would have not wasted his time chasing olive oil, and he would have stuck to the spinach. You've been sold a false bill of goods, and you believe that oils were good for you, and actually they're at the root of your weight problem. Hold it. Hold on. It actually gets worse. I have to tell you this. Fast food is not just linked to obesity, heart disease, and cancer in scientific studies. It's also linked to depression. Eating commercially baked goods like bread, muffins, cakes, croissants, donuts, as well as French fries, fast food hamburgers, hot dogs, and pizza causes depression. Published in the scientific journal Public Health Nutrition, the results reveal that consumers of fast food compared to those who eat little or none, are more than twice as likely to develop depression. Furthermore, a dose-response relationship was observed. In other words, the more fast food you consume, the greater the risk of depression. With regard to the consumption of baked goods, the results were shockingly conclusive. Even eating small quantities were linked to significant higher chance of developing depression. That is why so many people who have lost weight on this program have gotten rid of their depression. When you are unhealthy, eating poorly, and overweight, it is also more likely you're going to be depressed. Let's look at Laura from Missouri as an example. Laura watched my show on PBS and was shocked to find out that type 2 diabetes could be completely reversed. Laura had type 2 diabetes for 5 years. She also had high cholesterol, sleep apnea, and depression. She weighed 252 pounds, and at age 43 had given up hope of feeling good again because nothing had worked for her in the past. She said it was a light bulb moment when she heard me on her local PBS station because it made so much sense. She studied the materials, and within a few weeks, the weight just began to fall off. She wrote, "I was amazed. Not only did my weight drop quickly, but also my energy skyrocketed, and I didn't have a trace of depression. I was no longer in a fog and feeling sick. I felt alive and happy. And after a few short months, my type 2 diabetes, high cholesterol, and depression were gone. And I want to add that my cholesterol was lower following Dr. Furman's Nutritarian diet style than it was with 40 milligrams of a popular statin drug. I've lost 88 pounds so far, and I was able to reverse my sleep apnea and say goodbye to my CPAP machine. Thank you and PBS for saving my life." Now, Laura's results were hers alone, and yours might be different, even better. But it's the same story again and again. Eating the right mix of high-nutrient plant foods can turn on the body's self-healing engine. These nutrients take over your cell function, turning on the healing and self-repair sites on your DNA. And soon, you're no longer craving junk food and sugar. And the fog of uncertainty and depression lifts. It's like you're set free from prison and can take back control of your life. And you at home can do it too. You can do it easily, and you can love it like these people do. So let's review the three irrefutable facts about dieting. Number one, eating more vegetables, beans, fruits, seeds, and nuts will lower your weight. Number two, excessive amounts of meat and other animal products will increase your risk of cancer. Number three, eliminating refined carbohydrates, white flour, white rice, sugar, is important to stay slim. Do you think any legitimate nutritional scientist could or will disagree with those three statements? Go over those statements again, because I want you to be 100% certain that there are no controversies here. This is evidence-based nutritional science, and it cannot be denied. Fellow Americans, you don't have to be overweight and sick, and you can do this. Everyone in America can do it, especially if enough of us do it together. I know deep down, if you really believed it was possible to live to 95 to 105 in good health without medical problems and suffering, wouldn't you drink the Kool-Aid? Why not have a great life and a long, healthy life too? Don't you want to enjoy your life and be a fit and healthy elderly person? Especially that healthful food can taste even better than the low-quality foods Americans are eating now. And I can help you learn how to make those healthy, weight loss-inducing foods taste great. This is about enjoying life more, not giving up on the pleasure of eating. But if you don't eat healthy, you'll have a slim chance of losing weight. That's the point. If you eat healthfully, your weight will always be right and will never change. Because it's very difficult to be overweight if you eat lots of cancer-protective foods. If you eat enough of those foods, the fat melts off you in spite of eating a substantial amount of food. Plus, when you eat right, your body will automatically give you the right instinctual signals to stop eating when you need to. You eat when you feel like it, and you don't eat when you don't feel like eating. When the addictive drive to overeat goes away, you can't be overweight anymore, and you remain at your most favorable weight forever. Don't move from your seat, because when I come back in a few minutes, I will pull all of this together and give you those three important action steps you can take right now to fat-proof your body and change your life forever.
We're back with Dr. Furman's End Dieting Forever.
So, this is the part you've been waiting for. The secrets to permanent weight loss so you never have to diet again. Here's the number one secret. Eat more fiber-rich food. You have to eat more vegetables and beans to lose weight. And you have to eat bigger portions of them than you ate in the past. Don't forget that the emphasis here is on eating bigger portions of foods. And of course, I mean bigger portions of certain foods, not of all foods. But here are three foods I want you to eat every single day. Write this down. Number one, a big green salad. Number two, a bowl of vegetable bean soup. And number three, a large serving of steamed green vegetables. Super simple, but super effective. Let me explain more about the first rule of a nutritarian diet. It is eat a big salad as the main dish at least once a day. And here's the size salad I'm talking about. Now, there are certain ingredients you need to put in the salad to repair the messed up fat storage hormones and stop the body from storing fat, and they are raw cruciferous vegetables and raw onion. So I'm going to put some thinly sliced raw scallions or red onion on top of the salad. There, I did that. Wasn't too hard. Okay. And then I'm going to add some shredded red cabbage on top, or you could use Chinese cabbage or kale for your cruciferous vegetables. So we're putting some cruciferous vegetables on there too. And don't forget to add some tomatoes to your salad. Those are important and delicious. Put those on top. Great. Okay, I can also, you know, instead of a salad, I can make this into a wrap with a collard leaf or a cabbage leaf. You know, sometimes I take some cabbage, or here's a collard leaf, and I stuffed with sun-dried tomatoes that have been soaked, and some avocado, and a little bit of this healthy Russian dressing made by mixing together some low-salt tomato sauce, some almonds, a little balsamic vinegar, or your favorite vinegar, and a few raisins blended together. Doesn't that look good? Rolling it up. Yeah, I got two of them right there. Now, adding a quarter of raw onion or some scallions or shallots are key, because the regular use of onion is going to keep your weight down and make you live so much longer. Onions have flavonoids, quercetin, chromium, organosulfides, polyphenols, phytosterols. No, these are not the substances banned by Major League Baseball. They're healing phytochemicals that fight disease and keep you skinny, and they're found in onions. And the proof is right in the scientific literature. A massive European study showed 50 to 85% reduction in all major cancers from those eating a half a cup of onion a day. And using a little raw onion gives you more of those weight loss favorable compounds. Interestingly, the favorable bacteria that grow in the digestive tract from eating onions also aid in weight loss and prevention of diabetes and heart disease. In the Middle Ages, onions were such an important food that people would give them as gifts and pay their rent and other bills with them. Really. And by the way, in the summer, you can rub the onion on your skin to prevent getting bitten by ticks and mosquitoes. Really. Though I wouldn't recommend that right before you're going out on a new date. But remember, I put some cabbage or collards or kale on the salad too, because that's another weight loss inducing superfood. These raw cruciferous vegetables contain ITCs. ITC stands for isothiocyanates, which fuel our body's protective immune system and actually works to normalize and protect us against excess body hormones. Over 100 ITCs have been identified. They come from cruciferous vegetables, which include foods like Brussels sprouts, broccoli, cabbage, collards, arugula, bok choy, and cauliflower. Cruciferous vegetables should be eaten raw or steamed lightly. They, one, activate detoxification enzymes in the body, two, block abnormal cell division that could lead to cancer, and three, interfere with the growth of fat and help remove fat from the body. But since we're talking about this big salad that I want you to eat each day, we have to discuss the salad dressings. A commercial salad dressing full of salt, oil, and dairy products can turn the weight loss benefits of the salad into something that's not going to work so well. Because remember, each tablespoon of an oil-based dressing contains over 100 calories. Instead of oil, I want you to use those small superfoods that have powerful anti-cancer activity, and that's seeds and nuts. Here's one of my favorite dressings right here. I just blended a peeled navel orange with some toasted sesame seeds and a few cashew nuts with a splash of spicy pecan vinegar, or any vinegar you like. I love the taste of this dressing, and I know you will too. I also like to use walnuts, apples, cinnamon, nutmeg, and flax seeds to make another different dressing I call an apple pie flavored salad. Really is delicious. You see, it's important to have some of the fat from the nuts and seeds to facilitate the absorption of the fat-soluble phytonutrients in the salad, which increases its anti-cancer effects. Okay, we have the salad done. Now it's time to move on to the soup. The key ingredient in the soup are the mushrooms and beans, which are foods best eaten cooked, not raw. Many people are not aware of the magic power of beans. They fill you up, keep you satisfied for hours, and make you thin and healthy. That's because beans are high in fiber, high in slowly digestible starches that take many hours to be absorbed, and they contain resistant starches, which don't even get absorbed into the body. The resistant starch in beans lets the calories pass right through you and right out into the toilet. I'll bet you never saw a grown man so excited about beans. You would be too if you knew how they can work to lower your blood pressure, reverse diabetes and heart disease, and protect against cancer. Beans are the food most correlated with a long life in multiple scientific studies. For example, one important study documented that for each 2 tablespoons of beans eaten, death rates decreased by 8%. Guess if you eat enough, you'd live forever. But what I'm telling you today is that beans are a powerful weight loss food. So, shh, don't tell anybody. Don't tell anyone the secret to permanent weight loss. All right, fine, here it is. You eat more beans, greens, and onions because besides protecting you against cancer, they contain fat-reducing phytochemicals. Remember, you eat more beans, greens, and onions to lose weight. You don't count calories. Repeat after me. Onions, beans, and greens are the secret to getting lean.
Onions, beans, and greens are the secret to getting lean.
Right, you got it. So I want you to eat beans every day, especially from a bean soup or stew, which you can make once a week on the weekend. In this stew, right over here, I added some lentils, added azuki beans, collards, spices, water, vegetable broth, and 3 cups of chopped mushrooms. A healthy diet can contain some animal products if you like. You can even put a small amount in the bean soup or stew for flavor. But you have to keep in mind to just use a very small amount as a flavoring, not a big chunk on your plate like most Americans do. And that will keep your diet more affordable too. Not many people eat mushrooms almost every day, but if our population did that, death rates for most major cancers would plummet. And mushrooms are one of those foods that normalize your hormones and resist fat storage. The great thing about mushrooms is that even a little bit of them does a lot of good. For example, an important study published in the International Journal of Cancer showed that even a small amount of mushrooms, just 10 grams, the size of your thumb, can lower cancer rates by over 60%. And when they combined mushrooms with greens, the reduction in breast cancer was close to 90%. Wow. If green vegetables are the king of superfoods, then mushrooms are the queen. And before you know it, checkmate, you're on the road to optimal health. The beneficial compounds in mushrooms that prevent cancer and interfere with fat storage in the body are heat stable, meaning they continue to be effective even after the mushrooms are cooked. Of course, the last of the 3 secrets to long-lasting good health and permanent weight loss is to eat a big portion of steamed green vegetables every day. That means steamed asparagus, artichokes, string beans, snow pea pods, and other greens. I love asparagus, artichokes, and snow peas. And I know I can eat a big portion of food and to feel satisfied. Who wants to be on a diet and eat a thimble-sized portion of food when you can eat as much as you feel like eating? Now, you're not eating only these 3 dishes. You're eating other foods, too. But these are the 3 foods that you have to eat generously each day. When you follow my simple rules for permanent weight loss, the results for many people have been as good or better than gastric bypass surgery without the risk and health issues that result. For example, look at Gerald from Pittsburgh. He went from 334 pounds to 173 pounds in 1 year. That's 161 pounds lost in a year. And of course, his cholesterol and blood pressure normalized. His cholesterol went from 214 to 139. His systolic blood pressure went from 140 to 110. And he's off a slew of drugs he was taking for acid reflux and pain. Wow, losing 161 pounds in a year? That averages out to about 13.5 pounds a month. Now, I'm not saying that everyone loses their excess weight that quickly. Some lose it even faster, and some slower. But the point is that when you're eating lots of wholesome, natural food, and your diet is so nutritionally superior, then it's not dangerous to lose weight that quickly. And getting those 160 pounds off may have saved his life. Jerry said that during this entire time, he never weighed any food, didn't count one single calorie, or used portion control. He wrote, "I eat until I'm full. My taste buds also exploded during this time. Things that I would never have considered before, I just didn't even like, now I find myself craving." He said, "What surprised me the most was that as amazing as the physical transformation was, the change in my mental awareness was even more. I never realized I was in such a mental fog. The clarity and focus I experience now is difficult for me to put into words because it's so amazing." He makes the point that your perverted cravings, bad moods, apathy, and lethargy disappear. These people are now excited about living. The reason all these people were able to drop their excess weight so quickly and easily is because of what I call micronutrient fulfillment. Consuming enough micronutrients will do three basic things. One, reduce the desire to binge and overeat. Two, reduce the desire for processed foods and sweets. And number three, promote fat loss and prevent fat storage in the body. That's right. An optimal micronutrient intake takes away your fatigue and what I call toxic hunger, driving you to eat too much and too frequently. You'll no longer feel like you have to snack all day. When your diet is low in antioxidants and other micronutrients, you're forced to stimulate yourself with food all day long, like on one continuous addictive binge. Then the weight just snacks right up on you. I joke around a lot, but dietary-induced diseases are serious business, especially because the American diet is prematurely killing most Americans. Wouldn't it be better if what we ate helped us face and conquer life's challenges and simultaneously added quality years to our lives? Consider Robert from Ohio. Of course it's fantastic that he lost 200 pounds, but he's no longer in a wheelchair, and he can work all day on his feet. He was on 10 different medications. The Nutritarian diet cured his diabetes and his rheumatoid arthritis. And he was able to throw away all the drugs, including the four highly toxic, cancer-promoting drugs he was taking for his rheumatoid arthritis. The point is that people are suffering with severe chronic illnesses, migraines, crippling and painful autoimmune diseases, like Robert's rheumatoid arthritis. And it can make their lives worse than prison. Nutritional excellence is therapeutically effective. It can do what drugs cannot do. And it saves lives. Whether you feel ill or feel okay, whether you have 200 pounds to lose or just 20 pounds to lose, I know how frustrating it can be when you're not functioning your best. Now, I know many of you out there have spent your lives following the crowd, looking for a magic supplement that will work for you, or looking for the magic diet that will be the answer to all your problems. But I want to reinforce that you did not fail, but rather those fads and gimmicks and diets failed you. Some of you are even willing to have major surgery to cut out part of your stomach when all you have to do is eat more G-bombs. G-B-O-M-B-S. Greens, beans, onions, mushrooms, berries, and seeds. Your immune system's special forces. And now you know the secret to permanent weight control and real protection against disease. I want every one of you to get healthy, obtain a favorable weight, and never have a heart attack or a stroke. The way you get protected against heart disease is by earning a favorable weight, a favorable LDL cholesterol, and a favorable blood pressure without drugs. If you're requiring medications, then you're not protected. My point is, do not be satisfied taking medications for the rest of your life. Do not accept mediocrity when it's your life on the line. I hope this will wake you up and get you back on the road to great health. If you're still alive, you can improve your health. Besides eating healthfully, the second part of the equation is activity. Being healthy is not all about diet. It's also about exercise and purpose in life. But more important than exercise is avoiding staying sedentary for more than an hour. In other words, if you sit most of the day, you're going to be shortening your life, and you're going to find it more difficult to keep your weight favorable. Scientific studies demonstrate that sitting most of the day is as bad for your health as cigarette smoking. It's critical that you take activity breaks mid-morning and mid-afternoon so you not remain sitting all day long. And exercise equipment is everywhere. It could be a chair or a flight of stairs. Of course, exercising with the wrong equipment can make you fat, especially if that equipment is only a knife, spoon, and fork. So I want you to work part of the day standing up. So if the phone rings, stand up and answer it. And talk on the phone while walking around. Take frequent breaks from work and go up and down a few flights of stairs. But when you come back, prop up your laptop or your working space on top of a platform so you can work standing up for a while. I want you to learn some basic exercises that you can do anywhere, right in your office, while sitting in a chair, or even on a plane. So intersperse some exercise into your day. Don't sit for more than an hour at a time. Try to remain standing for at least 15 minutes after each hour of sitting. A nutritarian lifestyle, a lifestyle scientifically designed to protect against disease and push the envelope of human longevity, involves eating healthfully, remaining active, enjoying life and other people's friendship, and caring about others. These are the secrets to a long, happy life. I hope you get on board and join all of us to take better care of your health and the health of your family. In doing so, you'll be better able to help other people and maybe save some lives. I'm going to be traveling around the country visiting many of your hometowns, and I want to hear from you too. I want to hear about your success story and how you finally achieved great health and your ideal weight. Thank you for coming today, and thank all of you at home for listening and learning with me. I wish you great health and much happiness always. It can be yours. Thank you.
Information that Dr. Furman has for us. So now, Dr. Furman, please tell our viewers, what are the three most critical things you can do to live a long and healthy life?
The three most critical things. You ready for that? Okay. Here's my top tips to remember for a long and healthy life. One, stop deceiving yourself. Excuses and obstacles are not real. The primitive part of your brain works to maintain addictions with deception and fantasy and picks up any excuse it can to maintain itself. A little bit won't hurt. Everybody does it. It will cause more stress to change, everything in moderation, when in fact, harmful substances in moderation can be deadly. Number two, short versus long-term thinking. Every decision you make many decisions every day. You have to ask yourself, is this going to benefit me long-term or short-term? You know, is this going to enjoy for 10 minutes, for like 2 minutes as it's on my lips? Or am I going to get benefits of the last 10 or 20 years? Make the decisions that protect you and benefit you long-term, for years into your future. Long-term decision-makers are happier people, more successful, and live longer. And number three, don't be a victim of your past. Don't let past failures, mistakes, or health issues define who you are. You're not an addict. You're not a person who hates vegetables. You can cultivate the knowledge, habits, and skills to become who you want to be. And ongoing self-improvement and new interests and life's challenges lead to a longer life. So embrace these new challenges.
Dr. Furman, thank you for this program, for your research, for knowing how to teach us these lessons that are really going to help us live a healthful life. And you know what? Thanks to everyone who's called with your support. Your gift to this station is key to bringing more programs that can change your life. You know what? This is your public television station, and we really appreciate your support. I'm Laura Savini. Thank you so much.
Explore new worlds and new ideas through programs like this. Made available for everyone through contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
Be More, PBS.
Downton Abbey is a global television phenomenon with drama, scandals.
Don't do that.
And of course, romance.
Kiss me. Now.
Join us for a loving look back at the first four seasons of Downton Abbey.
Something to look forward to.
I'm Susan Sarandon. Please join me for Return to Downton Abbey.
A special treat for all Downton fans. Tonight at 7.
Houston Public Media satisfies your curiosity, makes you think, smile, and want to be involved. On air, online, and beyond.
Hello, I'm David Suchet. I've had the distinct pleasure of playing the Belgian detective Hercule Poirot for the entire run of the Poirot series on public television. Please join me for an enticing look back at 25 years of everything Poirot and a sneak peek of the upcoming new season.
Two decades of playing Agatha Christie's